Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Some Startropics, and I'm your host, Empolo. So, I was just outside smoking, which I know is terrible for me, and it's currently 9 degrees outside. Yeah. It's 9 degrees. It's not even double digits. Anyway, so we come over here. Hi, I'm Poe, the famous poet of the Southern Islands, like my poems. Raindrops from heaven, fountains spring from earth, lifting my spirit's high. Cool. Anyway, you can walk back down the path, but it's actually shorter just to walk off the map. Anyway, so we're still in chapter 3. Now saving your day, your frame, turning power off or resetting. Oh my goodness. Alright, so we have our mace of justice, which we can use to kill ropes. You really don't... Aw, crap. No, come here. No, you hurt me, and now I want to kill you. Okay, well, what about your buddy? Come here. Ah, no hearts. Okay. Anyway, so I figured the best way to warm up after being outside in freaking freezing cold weather is to play some Startropics. Anyway, so there's a secret tile here with a baseball bat. Baseball bats are nice. Alright, so these guys you can actually, like, start killing from a distance if you have the yo-yo. So it's not too hard. Aw, come on. I wanted that star. Alright, these tiles are not fun. Pretty much what these do is these will disappear when you jump on them. So what I like to do is get a head start on that skull. Kill him, jump across, and jump back. Now, these tiles, you can keep jumping on it. As long as you are jumping, it will keep, like, disappearing and reappearing. So, in that first room we saw the baseball bat, it's kind of a hint of what you can do over here. So you're like, how would I get to this button? Well, there's a secret tile. And these have some balas in them. So, and in case you guys don't remember, baseball bat, radial, all the way around, does about 2 damage, and the balas are full screen and do 1 damage. So, anyway, so we're gonna come down here. Well, hello, mysterious lava level. Hello, Mr. Purple. I don't know how that meme started. I haven't watched all of Josh Jepson's LP of Metroid Fusion, but I'm assuming that's how it spawned. Okay, these guys are not nice. Pretty much what I like to do is I like to just kind of strafe back and forth and see if I can get them to spawn. Otherwise, they, like, spawn in my way and kill me, and I'm like, ugh! Like, there should be... There we go. I was like, I think there's either 2 or 3 of them in here. I don't remember how many. 3. Okay. There's 3 of them. So. Door, and I don't think this button does anything. No, it doesn't. Okay. Yeah, I actually started my timer, and then I coughed, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna not have that in there. Oh! Did you see that? The bee! Anyway, just ignore this muddy guy. Oh, what the hell? Do I have to kill him? Do I have to kill you? I do have to kill you. That's lame. I thought there was a switch. Hmm. Oh well. Alright. These are also not fun. Jump over here. Okay. Okay, if you time that right, you can get those hearts. So. Alright. Another room. Okay. See, jump, 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 jump. Alright, let's see what's over here. Over here, we have... Oh, potion. I'll take a potion. Potions are nice. And some hearts if you need them. I don't need them, so I'm not gonna grab them. Okay, Mike, your turning sucks. Just letting you know. Alright, so disappear, jump, 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 jump. If you jump straight across, you should be okay. Alright, this room contains more of those evil, creepy pedophile guys. If they would spawn. Spawn! There we go. I think there's 2 of them. I don't remember. There we go. Ah! Cannot get me. Okay. In here, we have these guys. These guys are not fun. Now, I guess you can use your bolas if you want to. I mean, it kind of just goes across the screen, but then it's kind of hard to hit them again. You know, unless you time it right. Oh, I only had to kill 1? Oh, sweet deal. Oh, forget those two then. I guess it's kind of like that other room in the earlier dungeon where you only have to kill the one bat. Which really doesn't make any sense at all either, so... Alright! In here we have... a switch, which... makes this mummy appear. I just ignore him. Not really useful. Okay, so now for these guys... I am just gonna play it safe. I'm gonna get some distance and just start hammering him with... bolas. Well, until I run out, and then I'm gonna switch over to my other one. Actually, I should probably use this weapon first. you don't look... Oh, hey, crazy idea. Let's see if this works. Come here, come here. Ow, you butt munch. I'm gonna kill you. Come here, come here. No, you... Ow, no, stop hurting me. Okay, well, now that I've been hurt twice, not very fun. What's in here? Mysterious room with nothing in it. Okay. And that guy's probably gonna respawn, isn't he? Yes, he is, but I don't really care, because... Don't hurt me. Thank you. Oh, you are not fun. Run! Run away! Let's see if I can get him to come at me. There we go. I've only got 7 bolas left. In here... Switch... Switches... Plural, actually. Alright, let's go this way. See what's down here. A... Switch, which... Reopens the door. Ah, lame. Alright. Well, let's just do this switch then. Oh, okay. Okay, which... No, I want the... Oh, wait, it already opened. Okay. In here... Oh, crap, another one of you. Crud! Not fun, not fun, not fun. Okay. Get you... What's in here? Oh, a snake! Alright, so now I think this just wraps around, doesn't it? Well, that's one of those in it. Nah, full pass. Alright, anyway, come through... Where is that? There it is. Here, and if you listen to the man with the poem, you just jump on the fountain. This is the only case where you can jump into or on water and Michael won't die. And it thrusts us to the top of the mountain. Blah! You've done it! Congratulations! Oh, you're saving my data. Thank you. Good luck. Hello. You came very far in searching my spell. Oh, you are fantastic. I'll give you the scroll of Obob. We got the scroll! Don't mention it. Hurry and save the girl. Which, I'd fast forward through it, but I didn't realize that when you fast forward in here, it just, like, puts it back to normal speed in the rendering, so. Read the scroll. It's just a bunch of dumb gibberish. It's a Miracola! Yawn! Good morning, Daddy! Alright, so... Yes, thank you. The repair of my ship. What's GTFO? Hey! Ready for lunch. Thank you. So how's everybody today? For confession, the subsea small island appears on the horizon. On the horizon? Ah! Okay, this I think I can just ignore. I don't really need to go there. But anyway, this is Tuna Cola. So, there's nothing really important there. Unless I have to go there like it's scripted before whatever else happens. Dang it, it is scripted. Curses. Wait, no, is it? Yes? No? Yes? Okay, it must be scripted because I'm not going anywhere. Dang it, I did not want to have to come here. Okay, I guess it is scripted that I have to come here. Lame! Really? Oh, one cool thing, you can, like, come in and out of the ship right here. I just thought that was cool. So I guess it's scripted that I actually have to come here and talk to everybody. I'm a fisherman. I've missed a big one, as big as a whale. My daddy's a fisherman. Good for you, you little whore. I'll become a good fisherman like your dad. Alright. Have you ever heard of the raw fish eaters island of Sushicola? I'm a fisherman. Welcome to Tunicola. Yeah, I already explained that. My name is Bait. Today, I met a guy sailing. Ooh, okay. Rowing his raft? Huh. Let's go check it out. Now that I've done this scripted event. Stupid scripted events. Well, I actually wonder how far out it is. One, two. Oh, it's only two. Yeah, it's only 2 seconds out. So, yeah, that was definitely scripted that I have to come to that island first. Anyway, so we're in the belly of the whale, which is a great song by the Newsboys. You should check it out. Wow, Mike, it's me, Baboon. Dr. J's assistant, do you remember me? Yes, last found you in the belly of the whale, blah. So then Cross gave me courage to find you, but I was scared. Make him sneeze, we could build a fire. Give me a lighter, but it fell out of the pocket that you don't have in your Speedo. Alright, well, I guess we can go find it. Okay, I don't quite remember the correct way to go around here, but I do remember you have to, like, sail around. Okay, I think this is the way I came, wasn't it? No, it's not. Okay. Yeah, there's a couple dive spots in here, which I don't understand how we can, like, dive in and out of the innards of the fish, but I'm not to really question the logic of Startropics. It's not my place. Oh, not there. It's somewhere else. It's not here, either. It's here? Yeah, because, like, if you walk around, you actually, like, go the wrong way, and you can't get to the lighter. Dum 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 gnomes, gnomes of gnomes, gnome 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 gnomes, gnomes gnomes. Yep, and if you does it show it the bubbles? No. Anyway, you can go under there. And then down. Yes. Is this where it is? I think so. This had better be where it is or I'll be mad. Yes, here it is. This giant human-sized lighter. Yeah, because if you walked around from this top side, you wouldn't be able to get here. Oh, dang it. Well, it's so cold outside, I, like, powered through my SIG, and now, like, it's just blah. Anyway, I think this dive spot takes us right back to Baboon. Yes? Oh, it takes us to this T-intersection with one pallet, which is just north. There we go. And you have to come to this little dock spot. Oh, hey, let's build a fire. And it's getting smokier. And smokier. There's smoke in his eyes. Achoo. And we're gonna make like Jonah and GTFO. And land on this convenient island. Well, that was convenient. Wow, you're really thin from the side. Whew! You have aliens from a distant planet. Tell Mike to dip my letter in water. Do you understand? Yes. Dr. J has been abducted by aliens on a flying ship. Leave me here, okay? Alright, now, before I get back in the ship, I'll explain something. Back when the game was released, you would buy it, you know, in the box, and, you know, Startropics is really cool, whatever. Anyway, and you pull it out, there's the game and the little, you know, dust cover or whatever. Well, and the instruction manual came in the letter. And I suppose I could throw a screenshot of the letter up while I explain it. Anyway, so what it is the letter, you know, you read it, you know, hey, Dr. J, whatever. And, you know, it's just signed Dr. J. And the Babu says, you know, dip the letter in water. Well, what was cool was, is if you dipped the bottom of the letter, the producers of the game used a special ink that would only show up underwater, like when it comes wet. And there's a code on the bottom of the letter. So when you come in here, it says Navcom Captain Input Frequency. Now, if you didn't have the original game or that came with the letter, you wouldn't know the frequency, or, you know, or unless you asked one of your friends, or you, like, nowadays we have the internet and you can find it. But the code is 747. Aye, aye, frequency tracking system set for Dr. J's location. If I pick up a signal, I'll alert you. Subsea is ready for launch. Anyway, and that'll just throw us right into, you know, Chapter 5, which we're going to do next time. So, Captain Bell, Subsea is searching for Dr. Jones' location, but the strait is blocked. Oh, no! Yep, it's blocked by this giant ship, which really is only slightly bigger than my ship. Anyway, but we're going to dock here, and I'm going to save, because this time I'm actually recording. The last time I did this, I forgot to start the movie recording, and it didn't go. But anyway, so next time on Startropics, we're going to see what's going on with this island and some Captain Bell and get the ship out of the water. So, see you guys next time. Bye-bye. And...